The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is. Fourth chapter, text number 13, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 2nd of April, 1974, in Bombay, India.
According to the three modes of material nature and the work ascribed to them, the four divisions of human society were created by me. And although I am the creator of this system, you should know that I am yet the non-doer, being unchangeable.
Chaturbarna maya system gunabarna vibhava dasa kartaram api maam vidhi akartaram abhayam. So, beginning of human civilization is this varnasam dharma. The Vedic system is varnasam dharma. The people known as Hindus in the world, the Hindu is a term given by the Mohammedans from Indus. Indus River is there. Now it is in Pakistan. So people beyond the Indus River, the Mohammedans in Arabia and other countries, they pronounce S as H. Instead of Sindhu, they used to pronounce it as Hindu. So people living, crossing the river Indus or Hindus, they were called Hindus. Otherwise, this Hindu term is not seen in any Vedic literature. The real meaning is the people who observe the varnasam dharma, four varnas and four ashrams. Four varna means Brahman, Kshatri, Vaishya, Shudra. And below the Shudras, they are called Chandalas, Panchama, fifth grade, less than the Shudras. That natural division is there everywhere. Brahmana means the most intelligent person. Intelligent means one who knows, who has got sufficient knowledge. Brahmana means he has got sufficient knowledge even up to the understanding of the absolute truth. Brahma janati iti brahman. So that is first class men, brahmana. The intellectuals are very intelligent class of men. There are everywhere, all over the world. You may call them brahmana or not, but a class of men, very intelligent, that is available in every part of the world. So brahmana means the intelligent class of men. And kshatriya means less than the brahmanas. And vaishyas means less than the kshatriyas. And shudras less than all of them. It is a question of intelligence. The Chaturvarnam Maya system, Krishna says, these four varnas are created by me. So anything created by God, that is not monopoly for any class of men or for any country. Just like the sun is created by God. The sun is the thing which is enjoyed by all parts of the world. But there are countries, Western countries, where sun is not visible, covered by the clouds. Any country, any part of the world, which is covered by cloud and the sun is not visible, according to Shastra, such country is condemned. because although the sun sign is there, but certain condition, they cannot enjoy the sun sign. Therefore, from the Western countries, when people come to this country, especially in India, when they see from the Arabian Sea bright sunshine, they very much become astonished, how nice sunshine is here. The sunshine is the property for everyone. But according to intelligence or according to fortune, they enjoy it. So Brahminical culture also the similarity. It is just like sunshine. It is meant for everyone. But the people must be intelligent enough to take it. Unfortunately, this system, although India was observing very rigidly, now it is slackened or practically nil. We have lost our Brahminical culture, the Chaturvarnam Maya system. This is the due to the influence of Kali Yuga, Kalau Sudra Sambhava. In the Kali Yuga, practically everyone is a Sudra or less than Sudra. Less than Sudra is called Chandala. Sudras, sometimes Sudras also eat meat, but the less than Sudras, they have no discrimination. They eat even dogs. The dog eaters, they are described in the Shastra, Sapacha. Swa means dog, and pacha means pachyanti, cook. But Krishna consciousness is so nice. It is said in the Shastra, Ahavato sapachopi guriyan, yajjibhadri namatubham. Even a sapach, jandar, dog eaters, if he learns from the spiritual master how to chant Hare Krishna mantra, he is guriyan, he is glorified. In another place also, that sapacho, Chandalopi Dijasrashta Hari Bhakti Parayana. Even Chandala, he becomes greater than a Brahmin, provided he becomes a devotee of the Lord. Hari Bhakti Parayana. So ordinarily, when people are not on the standard of Bhagavad Bhakti, devotees of the Lord, there is division of the society. There must be. Otherwise things cannot go on. In the Shastras we find that there is division even in my body. The brain division, the hand division, or the arms division, the belly division, and the leg division. The brain division is the Brahmin. And the arm division is the Kshatriya. Gives you protection. As soon as somebody is going to attack you, immediately, automatically, you spread your hand. Kshatriya. Khat means injury. In Hindi it is called Khatra. So, Khat Trayate. The Khatriya's business is one who can save you from being injured by others. That is Kshatriya. And Brahmana means the intelligent class. As in the body, the brain is also required, the hand is also required, the belly is also required, and the leg is also required. Although the activities of the leg is not so important than the activity of the brain. Comparatively studying, The brain is most important part of the body, this head. If you cut the head of a man, then in spite of possessing the arms, belly and legs, he is dead man. But if you cut the head or the leg, he can live. And the brain can work. This is an example. Similarly, when the society is divided nicely in these four divisions, the Brahminical culture, the Kshatriya culture, the Vaishya culture, and the Sudra culture. Brahminical culture means people should learn how to speak truth, satya, sama, how to control the mind, how to control the senses, satya, sama, dama, titikha, how to become tolerant, arjava, how to become simple in life, how to become clean, how to acquire knowledge, and how to practically apply the knowledge in daily life. Jnanam vijnanam astikam. And astikam means full faith in the Vedic literature. That is called astik. Astika generally is called atheism. So, if one has full faith and full knowledge in Vedas, he becomes theist. If he has no sufficient knowledge in the Vedas, he becomes atheist. So, just like Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Vedna maniya buddha hoila nastik. The Buddhists, they did not accept the authority of the Vedas. Therefore, they are called nasti or atheist. That is the definition. That if you do not accept the authority of the Vedas, then you become atheist. So, this is the Brahminical, one of the Brahminical qualifications is how to live under the Vedic civilization. That is Brahma. Similarly, Kshatriya, Teja, Shaurya, very powerful, and Kshatriya will never go away from the battlefield. Kshatriya's business is in the battlefield either to become victorious or lay down life. That is Kshatriya. He is not coming back from the battlefield without being victorious. No. That is Kshatriya. Not like Kshatriya, therefore they are in charge of the government. Nowadays, the Kshatriyas, they do not go to the government. Practically there is no Kshatriya. That is stated in the Shastras. Asamaskrita kriyahina mlecha rajanna rupina. Mlecha. They have no Kshatriya qualification. Mlecha, unclean. Mlecha means unclean, without any Vedic culture. They are called mlecha. Anyone, it does not mean that any particular class of man is called mlecha. Anyone who is unclean and does not abide by the injunction of the Vedas, they are called mlecha, javana. That is the Shastrita. So, Krishna says, for the upkeep of the society, there must be this cultural division of the society, namely, varna and asra. But at the present moment, people do not know what is the aim of life. They do not know. Nati vidu sātra pratinhi viṣṇu durāśayādi bahirattamāni andhājathāndhai rupaniyamāna stepiśatantra urudāmni badhyā urudāmni badhyā stepiśatantra urudāmni badhyā People, and because the Vedic culture is lost, the system of Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya is no longer existing, neither there is training. One politician, minister in Calcutta, he came to see me, I was talking. So why there is chaotic condition? And the simple reason is, there is no, this Chaturvarna system is lost. Practically, without any Brahminical culture, Kshatriya culture, people remain Sudras, the fourth class men, or fifth class men. So unless there are first class men, second class men, at least third class men, only fourth class, fifth class, sixth class men, how they can conduct? That is not possible. Therefore, it is enjoined, the Chaturvarnamaya system, this division of the society must be observed. Educational institution there should be, but the education, just like in university, there are different departments, medical department, engineering department, or biological, and so many, psychological, chemical, physical, there are so many departments. But there is no department Brahminical, Kshatriyakal or Vaishya, nothing. Because they do not know what is the aim of life. They are simply interested with the bodily comforts of life, that's all. Never mind what is our next life, what kind of life we are going to, but that is a fact. Therefore we have to study Bhagavad Gita very seriously. The beginning of Bhagavad Gita, it is said by Krishna, Tatha Dehantara Prapti. There is Dehantara. After leaving this body, I have to accept another body. Tatha Dehantara Prapti Dhirastatva Namayati. Dhiro means those who are sober, intelligent. They know that what is death. Death means giving up this body and accepting a transmigration of the soul. That is death. So dhīra-stato namayya. A dhīra who is learned, he knows. But others, adhīra, there are two classes of men. Dhīra and adhīra. Adhīra means not control. Animals. Yes, an animal cannot control. The human being is gradually coming to the platform of the animals because they are being conducted on the bodily concept of life. Yashyatma buddhi kunape tidhatuke sadhit kalatra disubhomayujyadhi jatitha buddhi salile nakarhite saiva bhokha. Anyone who is thinking that I am this body, yashyatma buddhi kunape. Kunapya means this bag, tridhatuke, a kapavitta bhai. Am I this body? A first class intelligent man is composed of this body. What is the composition? Blood, bone, flesh, muscle, stool, urine. Does it mean a first class man is composition of these ingredients? But foolish people are taking their bodily conception of life. No. Tathādehāntara-prāpti. Dehi-nasmin-tathāde. This is the first understanding of knowledge. But people do not understand that within the body there is soul. They are so full. Therefore they have been described in the śāstra, sāyavad-gokhar. This class of men, they are no better than the cows and the asses. So you cannot become happy in the assembly of some animals. Therefore people are so much disturbed at the present moment. There is no sober life, zero. If you want peaceful life in the society, then you must accept this program, Chaturvarnamaya system. There must be. Brahminical class of men, Kshatriya class of men, Vaishya class of men, the Vaishya. Generally we understand Vaishya means the mercantile class of men. No. At the present moment, the so-called Vaishyas are Shudras, less than Shudras. Why? Vaishya's business is Krishi Goraksha Vanijyam Vaishya Padma Swabhava. The Vaishyas must be engaged in producing food grains, but they are not interested. They are interested in opening factories for bolts and nuts and tires. Goodwill tires, Goodyear tires. Now eat tire and bolt nut. Now you cannot eat. You have to eat rice, and rice is 10 rupees per kilo. That's all. Because now Vaishya is producing food grain. This is the defect. They don't see the defect. They simply howling, bawling. Oh, it has increased price. Why not increase price? There are millions of people in Bombay city who is producing food there, but they are known as Vaishya. What kind of Vaishya? There is no Brahminical culture, there is no brain, there is no Kshatriya who can give you protection. There are so many defects. So, if you want to remodel your life, the society, the human society, nationally or internationally, everything is spoken here international, then you have to take to the advice of Krishna. This is the purpose of Krishna consciousness movement, wholesale, thorough overhauling of the human society. We have not manufactured anything, concocted things. It is very scientific. If you actually want to fulfill the mission of your life, then you have to take to the advice of Bhagavad Gita. Very scientific and spoken by the Supreme Personality of Godhead without any defects. If I speak something, there may be so many defects because I am imperfect. Every one of us is imperfect. We commit mistakes. To err is human. There is no human being who can say boldly that I never committed any mistake. That is not possible. You must commit mistake. And sometimes we are illusion, pramam, that we are all, because we are accepting this body as I am, which I am not. This is called pramam, brahm pramam. Then vipralisha, I have got brahm. I commit mistake. I am bewildered. I am illusion. Still, I am taking the position of teacher. That is cheating. If you are defective, if you have got so many defects in your life, how you can become teacher? You are a cheater. Nobody is teacher. Because without being perfect, how you can become teacher? So this is going on. And the last defect is that my senses are imperfect. I cannot see properly, I cannot smell properly, I cannot touch properly. So many defects. Just for example, I am seeing the sun every day, but I am seeing just like a disc. But it is 1400,000 times bigger than the earth. So Shastra Chakushyat, you must see through this Shastra, not with these eyes. Just like they say sometimes, can you show me God? Have you seen God? Well, can you see God? You cannot see even the sun properly. How can you see God? Why you are proud of your eyes so much? If you cannot see even material object, and you cannot see even the spirit, soul. You are seeing daily your father. And when a father dies, you cry, oh, my father is gone. Well, your father is lying here. How do you say your father is gone? No father is gone. You know, how it is gone? Now he's dead. How is dead? That means you are seeing your father so many years, but you did not see who is your father. Now he cries, now my father is gone. Well, where is gone? He's there, lying on the floor. Just see our, how much defective our eyes. I am seeing the body of the father and I am thinking, he is my father. So he will go for ass and cow. The seeing of the ass and cow. In this way, we are defective. How we can guide the people? How we can become teacher? How we can become leader? Andhadathandhirupaniyamana. I am andha, blind, and I try to lead others andhas. Therefore, there must be chaos. This will not help us. We must see through the eyes of Krishna, the Supreme Personality of God. We must study Bhagavad Gita perfectly well. How to read? Evam parampara praptam. Through the disciplic succession. As Krishna said, you have to accept that teaching through the disciplic succession, not concocted meaning. I am a very good scholar. I passed my DSC or MSc or MA. I can comment on Bhagavad Gita in my own way. That is raskelda. That is not understanding of Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita means you must understand what Krishna says, that is understood. But generally it is done, kill Krishna. There was no Krishna, there is no battlefield, there is no Mahabharata. I have my concoction about Krishna. This kind of commentary and understanding of Bhagavad Gita has spoiled the whole world. Therefore, in the Western countries, so many Swamis and Yogis went there. And they misrepresented Bhagavad Gita. Of course, everyone knows in Western country Bhagavad Gita. Every institution, every gentleman, learned man, knows that there is a nice book, Bhagavad Gita. But they read these faulty commentaries, they cannot understand. Now we are presenting Bhagavad Gita as it is, and they are now understanding what is real Bhagavad Gita. Therefore, they are now devotees. For the last 200 years, so many Swamis and Yogis went there and talked about Bhagavad Gita. Not a single person became a devotee of Krishna. Now you'll find thousands. Why? The Bhagavad Gita is being accepted as it is. This is the secret of this Krishna consciousness movement. So, our only request is that if you want happiness, if you want to prosper, make your life successful, you must read Bhagavad Gita thoroughly as it is. As Krishna says, don't try to misinterpret. Krishna means this, Pandava means this, and this means this. Don't make this foolish raskalda. Take as it is, Bhagavad Gita. Krishna says that matta parataraṁ nānyā kintijasti dhananya aham mādhidhi devāna chātudvarnaṁ maya sriṣṭhāṁ. Here it is said. If Krishna says chātudvarnaṁ maya sriṣṭhāṁ, you cannot cancel this system of varnāsaṁ, then you'll suffer. You cannot cancel. You must accept that there must be a class of men, real Brahmana. Not that I am born in a Brahmin family and I am doing the work of a cobbler, still I am a Brahman. No, not like that. Gula karma vibhagasa. Krishna never says the Brahmin is born in a Brahmin family. Yet it is clearly said, chaturvarna maya system guna karma vibhagasa. Guna means quality. as you purchase something, that it is good quality, nice quality. Similarly, you should accept a Brahmana, a Kshatriya, a Vaishya, a Shudra by the quality and by the work. Not only that, just like you qualify yourself as a lawyer, but you do not practice, so who will call you lawyer? Nobody will call. But if you are qualified and if you are practicing, everyone will say, okay, sir. You'll go, people will go to consult with you. But if you do not practice, simply have passed and legal examination, nobody will come to you. The two things are required. The Brahminical qualities and work like a Brahmin. These two things must be, if you are born in a Brahmin family and you are all blessing to you. So what power you have got to bless me? You are not in quality, not in work. But people accept it. Panditji. What kind of Panditji? Pandita. Pandita means one who knows. Then Bhagavad Gita says, Pandita Samadarshina. Vidya Vinaya Brahmani. Gopi Hastini. Sunicheta Sapaketa. Pandita Samadarshina. This is the Pandit definition of Pandit. Not this rascal Pandit, that rascal Pandit. Pandit means one who has attained the spiritual platform. That is called Pandit. Pandita Samadarshina. Vidya Vinaya Brahmani. A learned Brahmin. A gobi, a cow. Hastini, an elephant. Sunit. Sunit means chanda. Sunit means dog. And sapa, those who are dog eaters. Chanda, Pandita Samadarshana. How is that? Pandit has become mad. He is seeing the Brahmin, learned Brahmin, and a chanda, and a cow, everything on the same platform. How? But because he is not seeing this body, he is seeing the soul. That is Pandit. Otherwise, how is Pandita Samadhar? He is not madman. Those who are advanced in education, learning, they see that everyone is living entity, part and parcel of God. He is under condition now. So, let him be awakened. Uttishtata, Jagrata, Prapta Varan, Nibodhata. This is Pandit business. To educate, to try the human being, one who hasn't got the spiritual knowledge, it is the business of the Pandit to educate him. Uttishtata, Jagrata, Prapta Varan, Nibodhata. You have got now this human body. In the animal body you could not understand what is spirit, soul, what is God. Now you have got the opportunity. Uttishtata. Now get up. Prapta varani bodhat. You have got this opportunity to understand. Adhata brahma jigyasa. Now it is your opportunity to inquire about jivasya tattva jigyasa. These are the instructions in the Vedic literature. Tattva jigyasa. The human life is only meant for tattva jigyasa, to understand the absolute truth. And that requires Brahminical culture, not the dull brain of Shudras and Chandalas. They cannot understand. Therefore, there must be an institution to educate a Brahmin, to educate Kshatriya. That is required. Chaturvarna Maya system. If you don't do it, if you simply produce Shudras, bolt nut manufacturers, technicians, then how can be happy Shudras? This is the business of the Shudras. This is not business of Brahmana. You keep Shudras, but there must be Brahmanas also. Just like leg is also required, the brain is also required. You cut the leg, simply keep the brain, that is also defective, and if you cut off the brain, then everything is finished. This is going on. There is no Brahmana. There is no Kshatriya. There is no Vaishya, only Shudras. So how can be happy? Therefore, it is very essential to understand this verse. Chaturvarna, ten, a class of men. Everyone equal. Very intelligent class of men. But their brain is being misused, an intelligent man is being taught technology to how to manufacture machine. This is Sudra's business. This is Sudra's business. Misused, brain misused. There must be university where brain is properly utilized. Here is a child, or here is a boy. He has good intelligence. Train him as Brahman. Less than that, train him as Kshatriya. Train him as Vaishya. Everything is there in the Bhagavad Gita. There is no difficulty. See, if you actually want happiness, prosperity of the society, not only of this society, but all human society, they must accept this Krishna consciousness movement, and then they will be happy. Thank you very much.